three, five, four, three, two, one.
He's awful. I'm gonna say awful.
Being a father can be a difficult thing at times. I mean, all of us have had these problems. Some of us.
I haven't.
Did you have your? I'm so.
No questions on the
end. Just go.
Things happen, and craziness can happen along the way. But at the end of the day, you can know that I would know that I've raised my child the best I can possibly raise my child. So today I'd like to share with you a little bit about how to be a great father. The first step to being a great father is to know your child. When you effectively know your child, you know what they love. Like, for instance, I know that my kid's two, but my kid loves Trinidad James. So I make sure that I have videos, and my kid loves rap, and I can't help that my kid's 2 years old and loves rap. I mean, I don't know that, but I'm gonna do things that he loves. I'm doing things that my child loves, and then we can connect on another level. Because all that parenthood is really bonding with your child so that you can do things with them, and they love you. And when you bond with your child, they're reciprocating that love. Your love and their love is the best thing that you could ever do.
But what makes you a good father?
Questions at the end.
Hold your questions.
Please hold your questions, sir.
When you're a good father, you are doing the things that your kid loves. Why are you laughing? But... Okay, besides that, sometimes my kid... Your kid might love Capri Suns. I'm sorry. Why are you... Hey, no. But sometimes your kid loves Capri Sun.
Sometimes.
And I'm gonna give my kid Capri Sun because I love my child. I don't want my child to hate me because I can't give him the delicious drinks that he needs. You know what I'm saying? Like real talk. Hashtag real talk. Like my kid. Hey, because my kid is gonna grow up into the YouTube atmosphere, and it's gonna sell the stuff to me. But I just want to know that I'm a good father. At the end of the day, I'm a good father. Now I'll open it up to questions.
You.
I have a question.
I'm sorry. Man, wait. Wait. Please state your name and where you work for.
Jacoby Williams. International Dildos Environment of America.
Incorporated.
You never told us what makes you a good father. Can you answer that?
I'm a good father because I keep mine real.
Capri Sun.
I keep my shit real.
Capri Sun.
Real fathers.
It's like sugar.
Know how their kids are. And they're to do anything that happens. Because every real father knows that once your kid is 4, it's easy to take care of your kids when they're 2, but it's a lot harder to take care of your kids when they're 18 and real shit happens. You gotta be ready to like deal with things. Next question.
There's a question over there.
I'm sorry, everybody. Please state your name and where you work for.
I'm John Johnson from Johnson Incorporated. Johnson & Johnson.
It's all Johnson's.
What happens when keeping it real goes wrong?
Sometimes we're keeping it... A lot of things can happen. Like, for instance, say that I'm a woman.
Is that wrong?
No, it's okay. But for instance, we'll say that I'm a woman. And I caught a girl. Whoa. I caught a girl, like, prank dialing me on my phone. And I don't know who this girl is, but I said, hey, I can either keep it real or I can just let it go. So I would say, I'm going to keep it real. I'm like, bitch, I don't like people playing on my phone. And then things escalate and I end up in jail. And I get beat up by 5 other girls because they kept it real more than me.
So basically,
you want to make sure that you keep it real to a little bit of a degree, but not the whole way.
That makes sense.
Next question. I'm sorry, sir. Please state your name and where you work.
My name is Ashton Smith. I'm a door-to-door soundproof crib salesman. earlier you had said... earlier you had said one of the key things was to get to know your child. Now, I agree with that completely. Can you tell me what kind of things you do with your two-year-old to get to know them better?
To add on to that, is it true if you get need to earn your man, do you need to learn your man?
I mean... So earn your man, you definitely need to learn your man, but with a child, it's a lot harder because kids aren't 30 years old. You have to connect with your child.
Kids aren't 30 years old.
Hold on.
I'm sorry.
I was going to go after you finish my original question, of course.
To connect with your child, there's lots of things you can do. For instance, one of my favorite directors is Mike Judge. He's done lots of different movies. Two of the biggest being Office Space and Idiocracy. And both of those perfectly depict our environment as a whole as we go. But they also have like a pretty good soundtrack. So to connect with my child, I show my child these movies because, one, I know that they can start to learn a lot of music throughout what I show them, but then also, too, they can know about how effectively our world is at this time, because our world is literally a bunch of juggalos that try to do crazy things together and just procreate. Doesn't even matter. It's just like I'm Amore Hovich right now, and you are not the father, but somebody else is the father, but I don't care because I'm trying to make babies and I'm trying to get this money on government. You know what I'm saying? So, we're trying to, like, not make that happen, if that makes sense to you.
If getting to know your child, you discover that the child did not belong to you, what would you do then?
I'm sorry?
If you getting to know your child, you discovered that the child did not belong to you, it wasn't yours, what would you do then, as a good father?
Kill it.
Well then, obviously I wouldn't be the father. So I can try to like help out as much as I can, but I'm not really that fatherly aid to the child. So I would have to walk away. And that sounds horrible, but I'm not the father, so like I have to walk away. I mean, I can give the kid a mixtape. I can give the kid some. I can be like, hey, this music will help you. I'm sorry. Why are people like this? I can give you this mixtape. Like, hey, this killer mic will help you along the way.
Sir,
to learn shit.
Excuse me, sir.
I'm not your father.
What kind of songs will Goodbye. Be on this,
sir?
Sorry.
When is the appropriate age to teach your kid about ass to mouth?
13. Wait. It completely depends on the sex of the child.
17.
No. If you have a boy, you should probably teach him around, I'm going to say 14, 15. Mm-hmm. But if you have a girl...
13.
I want to say 13 because either way, people love Sprite. A lot of people don't know what that means. You can bring back. When you love Sprite, it means you're thirsty. When you're thirsty, all thirsty means is like it means you're thirsty for like the opposite sex.
Dick.
So like.
Or the same sex.
Ask them
it's
out.
Leon Cola.
Thank you.
Just dick.
We live in a free environment. Or the
yes,
same
yes,
sex.
Yes, yes, yes. So some people do love the same sex, but you're thirsty, and you have to know that can't happen. I mean, that can't happen, but you have to make sure that you do.
No, you dominated the...
Question.
Question over here.
I'm sorry.
Snap!
If the man's role is to learn his child at an age when maybe the baby can't even talk, what is the woman's role? In raising the child.
Wait. This seminar is about how to be a good father.
To cook and suck dick.
To make
I would like to know
breasts.
If the man's role is to know the child. Yeah. What is the woman's
Excuse
role?
Excuse me, all we're going
to do
is have swollen milk. One question at a time, please.
So,
and also, a quick follow-up on that. I would also like to know how you learn to know your child when they can't talk.
So my kids can't talk, but my woman wants to know how to deal with my child.
Uh-huh.
So, like, the best way... Because women obviously don't know anything about kids and everything. So
whoa.
So the best thing is It's like kids wear the colognes. So like my woman can like be going to the mall.
Kids wear the colognes.
She can be buying me a cologne for my child. Cause like my kid loves Polo Black. So my kid wants Polo Black.
How do you know your girl?
She can go to the mall and she can buy Polo Black for my kid. Cause the kid, like all kids, really want on the very elementary levels to be bogged. Kids want to be bogged. Yeah. Like, if you go to any elementary school, always let the kids ridicule other kids because they ain't bogging.
That's
so, like, I want my kid to
be on an eccentric
level. But, like,
I'm talking. You answer that question. Answer another question.
I'm sorry.
Why did you name your first kid Tinchy?
Really practical question. Just two questions. He's done it in like 10 minutes. It's just a really simple thing, like when your kid's crying, but it's not like real crying. It's like attention-seeking crying,
yeah.
Like Chris Caraba or I don't know.
Hunter
Oberst.
False.
Where they're just sort of like, I feel like a really whiny, kind of fake. Like,
I sell a good product.
Like, just like a really, you know, like you just want to slap them.
Yeah.
So like, how do you handle that? When you know it's just really like stupid and immature and fake and just like self-absorbed and like shitty in every conceivable way.
Okay. Well, apparently, like when a kid cries like that, apparently you probably don't have good parents because they obviously hate Chris Caraba. So obviously the parents don't know what they're doing. On a whole, they don't know how to raise a child.
Okay.
But like, how you would raise a child is
the fate of your
like,
child.
Crazy stuff happens.
Really, when you really know.
Eventually. So